Good morning, everybody. Dr. Evan here. I just wanted to take a moment to say thank you to everyone for supporting the launch of my book on Kindle. The outpouring of support has really been amazing. I really appreciate it. I know we're going to help so many people with this book, so I really thank you. Thank you for sharing it. Thank you for talking about it. Thank you. So I also wanted to take this moment to talk to you a little bit today about my story with fatigue, so you can get a little background about who I am and why I chose to do this. So it all started really when I met my wife. So it was back in 2004. I had just moved to Olympia to start my family medicine residency program at the University of Washington program in Olympia. And I met her about a month in, and we just had a wonderful time, and she was social and bright and vibrant, and she was running her own business and a meditator and yoga teacher and all these wonderful things. And then after we'd been together for several months, all of a sudden she started to get tired and more fatigued, and until eventually she was incredibly fatigued, and she went and saw a naturopath, and she was diagnosed with chronic fatigue. And her adrenal stress index, her cortisol several times a day on a salivary test was completely flatlined. And so she didn't have any adrenal support in her body. And I was here in residency, and I loved this person, and I wanted to help her, and I could not. I felt totally powerless, and it was incredibly frustrating. And so I continued to go through residency, and she kind of did her own work with this. She started working on her emotional health, and she got a sauna, and she started to, you know, she read James Wilson's book on adrenal fatigue, and she started to get better. And the naturopath said it was going to take about 1 to 2 years, but it ended up taking 3 years. And that was just such a long period of time. And I was struggling through residency and trying to do my best to support her and really failing miserably at that. And then I came out of residency, we had a child, I started a business, all this stuff, all these wonderful things in my life. And then I started to get tired, and I started to get fatigued, and I kept pushing through. And I had come out of residency with knowledge in functional medicine, and I was treating people with fatigue, quite a lot of people, and I was learning more. And somebody gave me the book Fatigue to Fantastic by Jacob Teitelbaum, which was just an amazing book, totally revolutionized how I saw fatigue, how I was treating fatigue, and I was helping people with fatigue on a daily basis. And yet there were always people that I couldn't help. So I would get, you know, people better to a certain degree, and then I would go off and I would do another training, or I'd figure out another cause. And so I went from sleep, heavy metals, infections, nutrient deficiencies, lack of energy, which was kind of Jacob Teitelbaum's mantra, and then moved on to learn mold and heavy metals and chemicals from the American Academy for Environmental Medicine, and then on to learn more about infections from Dr. Hedberg and Dr. Horowitz. And so those were incredibly important pieces as I kind of kept improving, and I kept helping more and more people, because I'd get people to a certain level, I'd learn more, and then I could get them to the next level. So that was incredibly important in my evolution. Unfortunately, my energy started to go down, and I was just used to pushing through, not very good at taking care of myself. And, you know, my diet was great, my exercise really wasn't that great, but I was, you know, I didn't know why I wasn't feeling well. I was taking all the supplements that I was recommending for the most part, but I really wasn't going after some of the key problems like heavy metals, chemicals, molds, infections, some of the harder to treat things, because I was just trying to maintain and see my patients in my practice, trying to run a practice, and I was worn out. And so finally, when I started treating myself, and my energy was about, I don't know, 4 or 5 out of 10, if 10's ideal energy. And as soon as I started treating myself, within a couple of months, my energy started to improve, and it just kept going. It just took me prioritizing myself and my health and saying, enough is enough. I have all these wonderful tools treating fatigue. Why don't I go ahead and do that? So I went ahead and started treating myself and got my energy up to a 7 or 8 out of 10, which is really where I am right now, and starting to implement more exercise into my life and really trying to prioritize and create this vision for my life about what I really want, who I really want to be, how can I serve, you know, more people. And so that's where I'm at. But that's a little bit about my journey with fatigue and how I got to this wonderful place where I have all this great energy. I can run around with my daughter. And I don't feel guilty about not helping out at home and not being the best that I can be for my patients. So, and it's all in the book. All of this information, I talk about it a lot in the introduction, but all of the things that I had, you know, I was constipated. I had heavy metal, chemical, mold, infection, toxicity. I had everything, really, that I talk about in the book. And this is all information that I've gleaned. When I go to conferences, I talk to other providers and I ask them, what's the most powerful treatment that you have in your practice? And I learn about that treatment and I incorporate it into my practice. And so I feel like this, our practice and this book is really a conglomeration of like the best therapies that are available to people. So thank you for listening. I hope this kind of taught you a little bit about who I am, where I'm coming from, and what my mission is, because I really want to help 100,000 people get better from fatigue. And so thank you so much for your support and have a wonderful day. Bye now.